In this video, I am going to explain how many muscles attach on 12th rib. This is the most inferior part of rib cage. This is kind of tiny rib compared to other ribs. But why do I focus on such tiny rib? There is reason. 12th rib is indeed the most inferior part of rib cage. Thus, you can say 12th rib is intersection between lumbar spines and abdomen and rib cage. Okay, so below 12th rib there is abdomen. Above 12th rib is rib cage. Thus, when 12th rib got dysfunction or when related muscles get tight, maybe the tightness can affect both rib cage and abdomen, lumbar spines. That is why this is like intersection between core and thorax. Thus, related muscles are so important for both abdomen and ribcage. That is why I am going to explain what kind of muscles attach to 12th rib. Okay. Below 12th rib, on inferior part of 12th rib, mainly core muscles attach, of course. And on superior surface of 12th rib, mainly breathing muscles attach. Let's get started. Actually, many muscles attach to 12th rib. Let me explain from core muscle. By the way, this is 12th rib. Okay, first one is this one. This is external oblique. External oblique. This is the most outer part of core muscle, external oblique. Next one, if there is external, there should be internal, right? Internal oblique. This is it. Internal oblique is deep from external oblique. And there's one more core muscle, right? That is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis is the deepest layer of core muscle. Okay? External oblique, internal oblique, and transverse abdominis. Okay, next one is this one. This muscle attaches to ribcage. Of course, this one attaches to 12th rib. This is serratus posterior inferior. Serratus posterior inferior. Maybe you have not heard this muscle. This is important for stabilization of ribcage and spines. This minor muscle is important for stabilization. Okay, I'm gonna explain two more muscles from this picture. Next one is this one. This is part of erector spinae. This is iliocostalis lumborum. Iliocostalis lumborum, which is this one. This muscle also attaches to 12th rib. Next one is also part of erector spinae. This one is it. This is iliocostalis thoracis. Iliocostalis thoracis. See, there are many muscles attached to 12th rib. I explained 6 muscles from this picture. External oblique, internal oblique, transverse abdominis, serratus posterior inferior, iliocostalis lumborum, iliocostalis thoracis. Let's go to next picture. Okay, next one is pretty much deep layer. I'm going to explain five muscles. Next one is this one. This is breathing muscle, because this muscle attaches to superior part of 12th rib. This is external intercostalis. External intercostalis. Again, if there is external, there should be internal. There is internal intercostalis. You see, this one is it. Internal intercostalis. This is deep from external intercostalis. And there is one more layer of intercostalis muscle. You don't see it, but imagine it is the deepest layer. Again, you don't see this muscle in this picture. That is innermost intercostalis. Innermost intercostalis. So, three layers: external intercostalis, internal intercostalis, and innermost intercostalis. See, these are breathing muscles. So, next two muscles are kind of tiny muscle. The next two muscles are this one and this one. This long one is levator costrum longus. Levator costrum longus. Next one, this short one is literally shorter than longus. This is levator costrum brevis. Costrum brevis. Brevis means short. Longus means long, literally, right? So five muscles from this picture: external intercostalis, internal intercostalis, innermost intercostalis, levator costrum longus, levator costrum brevis. Now let's go to that last picture. Next one is the deepest layer. Okay, this is even deeper layer. You see external oblique, internal oblique, and you don't see transverse abdominis. But instead, you see new muscle. This muscle is kind of rectangular shape. And of course, this muscle attaches to 12th rib. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This muscle is friggin' important for low back pain, because this muscle attaches to transverse processes of lumbar spines, and of course, that attaches to 12th rib, and that attaches to pelvis. So when this muscle gets tight, that inhibits movement of lumbar spines, pelvis, and of course, that inhibits breathing. This is very important for core area. Quadratus lumborum. Okay, next one. Next one is these guys. This is inside of thorax. This is subcostalis. Subcostalis. So this is, you know, inferior to ribcage. But this one also attaches to 12th rib. This is tiny, minor muscle, but still, it's important for breathing. Subcostalis. But I didn't explain the main breathing muscle today. So what is the last one? Last one is, of course, this one, this dome kind of shape muscle. This is diaphragm, of course. Diaphragm, of course, that attaches to 12th rib. See, I explained many muscles today, but mainly there's two types of muscles attaching to 12th rib. First group is core muscles, such as external oblique, internal oblique, quadratus lumborum, transverse abdominis. And the other group is breathing muscles, such as external intercostalis, of course, diaphragm, and internal intercostalis, this kind of thing. That is why when 12th rib got fracture, or these muscles get tight, that of course inhibits movement of 12th rib. From that tightness, that can inhibit breathing, of course, and that tightness can create low back pain. That is why 12th rib is very important for both core and thorax. I hope this video gives you new idea of seeing anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.